हाय दोस्तों, मैं हूँ आदि
और मैं आपके लिए लाया हूँ एक नई स्टोरी।
इट वॉज अ ब्राइट सनी डे। आदि एंड फ्रेंड्स हैड कम टू द पार्क टू प्ले। गोलू वॉज रनिंग अराउंड टू कैच अ बटरफ्लाई। आदि वॉज क्वाइटली सिटिंग अंडर अ ह्यूज ट्री एंड वॉज रीडिंग अ बुक। गोलू ट्राइड हिज बेस्ट टू कैच द ब्यूटिफुल रेड बटरफ्लाई बट कुडंट। As the butterfly flies higher up in the air, Golu climbs up a tree to catch it, but the butterfly manages to escape again. Golu does not realize that he has climbed way too up. Genie, who was building a sandcastle, sees all the children running towards the tree. She runs in the direction and sees Golu up on the tree walking on one of the branches. All children and Genie start shouting and ask Golu to get down. But Golu, not understanding the dangers, stays there and smiles at everybody. Genie warns Golu and tells him that she will complain to mom and will never play with him and tell dad too. Meanwhile, in the branch of the same tree, a big green snake was asleep. On hearing the commotion outside, the snake got irritated. Genie keeps asking Golu to come down, but instead Golu shows her the tongue. Finally, Genie picks up a stick and starts hitting the tree. With all the noise, the snake comes out of the tree in anger to see who disturbed his sleep. Looking at the dangerous snake, all children start shouting and running. All of them hide themselves in the bush except Adi. Adi tells everyone not to run. The snake thinks it was Adi who disturbed his sleep, as everyone else ran away. The snake comes flying towards Adi to attack him. Genie warns Adi and Adi bends. The snake hits a rock and gets hurt. The snake again tries to hurt Adi and Adi once again escapes. Golu enjoys all this from above the tree. Adi winks at Golu and Golu winks back. The snake tries to bite Adi, but Adi repeatedly tricks the snake. The snake gets tired. Still, he hits back again. This time, Adi gets hold of the snake and politely asks him to stop and relax. The snake sighs. He tells Adi that he was sleeping and got disturbed from all the noise. He asks for forgiveness and says that he should have tolerated the little botheration. The snake praises Adi on how, despite of having the strength to harm, he chose not to harm. Adi explains that everyone loves life and no creature wants to die. He could have never harmed the snake. Adi further says that the children didn't know that the snake was asleep in that tree. Otherwise, they would have never disturbed him, because his mother always says that whenever possible, we all should help people in need and never do things that offend anyone. The snake agrees that he gets angry quickly. He says that looking at Adi's behavior, he seems to be different from other children. He asks Adi, "Who are you?" Adi introduces himself and tells the snake that he too is like other children. The only difference is that he loves helping others, and when someone thinks about others as well, people think they are different. The snake looks at Adi in awe and nods. The snake says sorry again, promises that he will try his best not to harm anybody, and the children can play around his house. All the children hiding in the bush come out. Everyone smiles. Golu sitting on the branch smiles too. And looking at the butterfly, he falls from the branch. The snake immediately helps Golu to land safely. Genie and Motu thank the snake for his kindness, and all of them form a circle around the snake and start playing. Children, this story teaches us that everyone prefers to stay peacefully and happily at their homes, and we should always take care that we don't offend or hurt anyone. See you with a new video.
अगर आपको हमारी स्टोरी अच्छी लगी हो तो हमारे चैनल को लाइक, शेयर और सब्सक्राइब कीजिए। बाय।